Good morning, students. Can we see my screen? Now, okay, good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about modeling and simulation of electric vehicle with MATLAB Simlink and also how to optimize the modeled electric vehicle using Simlink design optimization. Today content is here how to design electric vehicle by using MATLAB. Here the special block set, that is MATLAB toolbox and block sets are available here. What is the difference between toolbox versus block set? Means a toolbox is a collection of MATLAB functions, that is called M files, that extends the MATLAB to solve problems and other works. Here block set calls functions internally. This is the block set. This is the difference between toolbox versus block set. Block set calls the MATLAB function internally. Here the toolbox provides some static data analysis capabilities, while the block set provides an environment for dynamic modeling and vehicle component modeling and also with simulation. This is a speciality of MATLAB block set. Okay, today we are going to discuss about the powertrain block set. This powertrain block set provides a standard model architecture that can be reused throughout the development process. So that we are going to see about introduction to MATLAB powertrain block set. This is like toolbox. Then what are the control models available in the particular MATLAB powertrain block set? Okay, then how to design vehicle? This is using this powertrain blocks block set blocks. How to design vehicle? Then modeling of electric vehicle with MATLAB Simlink. Here there are different type of controllers and different types of power management techniques are available here. By using this, we are going to model the electric vehicle by using this MATLAB Simlink. Okay, then MATLAB modeling of electric vehicle. Here there are so many blocks are available, so many subsystems are available. Here first important one is your drive cycle source block. Here there are so many predefined cycle blocks are available here. Here what is the use of this drive cycle source block is it has to use to generate a torque vehicle velocity for a selected or specified drive cycles. Normally the specified drive cycles are stored in MATLAB with some standards, that is for example US standard, worldwide drive cycle standard. These are all simulated standards. This is available in MATLAB toolbox, that is MATLAB powertrain block set. Okay, by using this we can generate a standard or user specified drive cycles velocity versus time profile. Here in this blocks, the drive cycle blocks output is selected and specified vehicle longitudinal speed. You are going to see this briefly in the time of simulation. Then modeling of electric vehicle subsystems. Here each and every block having some subsystems are available. Here for example environment subsystem. In the environment subsystem, the vehicle modeling based on temperature and some other climatic conditions. Then what is the driver subsystem and power control train model. Here the controller block available with battery control model and particular motor train model based on that one. Yes. Then this is the passenger car block. That is the final one is the visualization subsystems block. This is the output scope block. Here each and every block we have to you have some subsystems. Okay, here the sample output comparison with different drive cycles. For example, we are by using this drive cycle source block, there are so many options are available here. Based on that we are selecting the block, select the drive cycles. Based on that you can analyze your performance of the vehicle, that is a electric vehicle performance. Then finally how to design and optimization of electric vehicle power management system. Here some more techniques we are going to discuss. Then finally, how to optimize your design for performance and cost. Performance means there is a speed and torque, so many parameters are there. In cost wise, here if you go for electric vehicle means the battery cost is more, so that we are optimize the parameters such as engine trade off conditions, so that this is your the special block is available in the special tool is available to optimize the design. Simulink design optimization, this is a Simulink design optimization tool is used to optimize your design. Then for the introduction to powertrain block set, here for the powertrain block set used to model and simulate automotive powertrain systems. Is already we discussed with this one. There is a powertrain block set provides standard model architecture, and we can use it for design trade-off analysis, component sizing, and control parameter optimization, and hardware in the loop test. Here hardware in the loop test nothing but real-time simulation. This is one type of simulation, and we can use the customized model by parametric components in a reference application with your own data. Or our simulated data, our subsystem generated simulation data. Then this powertrain block set provides fully assembled and reference applications model of automatic powertrains, including here there are the important electric systems are available in powertrain block set. For example, gasoline, diesel, hybrid, and electric systems. Okay, it includes all the system having component library for simulating engine subsystem, transmission assemblies and traction motors, battery packs, etc. And control model cells are available. Here there are a lot of built-in control models available in powertrain block set. Okay, here no need to code anything. For example, if you want to implement motor, if you want to implement some battery, if you want to implement some vehicle design objects, no need to code anything by using drag and drop. This is already in block format. All are know very well about Simulink. Here by using Simulink, that's you have to drag and drop the blocks, particular blocks. Here in terms of blocks, it means here not only with block, also with subsystems, also with a lot of inbuilt models are available here. For example, if you have to drag them by longitudinal drive model or passenger car or some other blocks that you have to drop, means you will get more number of subsystems are available here. No need to create any more subsystems by using this powertrain block set. This is the specialty of this tool. Okay, first here there are two primary purposes are there by using this inbuilt controller model. First, the controller models complete a powertrain system model, and second, built-in models serve as starting point of our total controller development. Here, by using this inbuilt controller model, design we are study with design trade-off, and we are able to simulate more number of times. We can use MATLAB to automate simulation and analyze the results. Okay, here another important one is by using this built-in control model with powertrain block set, we can automatically optimize the parameters. The advanced optimization function in here MATLAB optimization toolbox, along with your parallel computer toolbox, we can able to optimize the design parameters. Here for example, to reduce the overall simulation time, we can use parallel computer toolbox to deploy powertrain system models across the cluster and the computer cores. Here, what are the especially for vehicle design? This is the powertrain block set. Blocks available with so many blocks are available. Now we are taking only for vehicle design block sets are we are using. This is a vehicle body. This is a one DOF means a degree of freedom longitude. Then here a single degree, 3 degree, and also some load type, vehicle body total road load, how much mass of mass can carrying by the vehicle, and also drive cycle source. Here drive cycle source implement the drive cycles with different type of standards. Normally FT format is default one. Now we are changing the drive cycles with different cycle sources. Then the longitudinal drivers, it used to implement longitudinal speed tracking controller. Here powertrain design trade-off studies. In addition to the controller design and test, we can use reference applications for powertrain design trade-off studies such as emissions, fuel economy, and performance. Here this is our modeling of an electric vehicle with MATLAB Simulink. Here this is a drive power cycle source. So I already mentioned that this is the input to your electric vehicle system. These are normally by default it is a drive cycle source is FTP75. These are default cycle source. Here there are some more options are available here. For example, we are going to discuss some more drive cycles are there. Here environment block, and this is your longitudinal driver block, and this is your controller block. This is your electric vehicle section. Okay, finally we are going to see the visualization block. Here this example shows how to create an electric vehicle reference application projects using MATLAB. How to get this model? This model is already available in our MATLAB. Just you have to retrieve the project. Here you can make some modification. Based on that modification, we can able to design more number of types in electric vehicles. How to get the copy of the project file is, we are in MATLAB command window. Just you type auto block EV electric vehicle start. Now we are going to discuss about this one. Just you copy the file. Now we are getting the project file. Here the exact thing is available here now. Okay, this is our default drive cycle FTP. This cycle, the drive cycle. Here next one. Here there are drive cycle source block, environment subsystem, longitudinal driver subsystem, and controller subsystem, passenger car subsystem, visualized subsystems are available here. Here drive cycle, environmental block, and longitudinal driver block, and controller, and passenger car, and finally for visualization block. Here drive cycle source block generates some standard or user defined drive cycles, and environmental subsystem creates a variables including road grade, and these are the parameter we are going to concentrate. This is including road grade, wind velocity, and atmospheric temperature and pressure. Then the third one, the driver subsystem uses to generate normalized acceleration and braking commands based on the vehicle target and feedback velocities. Here next block is controller subsystem block. This block, controller subsystem blocks. This controller subsystem blocks having powertrain control model, that is PCM, with an electric power management system. Here passenger car system, this implements a passenger car that combines electric plant and drivetrain subsystems. Here you can see here electric plant and drivetrain subsystems. Here in drivetrain subsystems, here we can see the way vehicle brakes. This is environmental condition. This is environmental condition. The roadside. Okay. Then visualization systems. So that is your vehicle level performance. You can be able to see the output after simulation. Displays vehicle level performance, battery state of charge, and equivalent fuel economies results that are useful for powertrain matching and component selection analysis. Now we are discussing with this modeling of an electric vehicle drive cycle source block. Okay. Now this is a block, the black parameters, drive cycle source block. It has so many drive cycles are there. The FTP72, FTP75 US model, and for example, if I am default one is FTP75 drive source cycles. Now you can see the plot drive cycles. These are plot drive cycles. velocity versus your time cycles. This is a standard one. For example, nowadays researchers are more concentrated on this NEDC. The NEDC is nothing but your New European Driving Cycle Velocity. This is a model. This vehicle model. Now we are going to simulate this. You take it as input. How it is match with this our design in our visualization block here. Similarly, you can choose our WLTP block here. WS worldwide harmonized light vehicle test procedure block. These are one more drive cycle simulations test measurement with your harmonized light vehicles test performance versus your time period. Now we start with this one, that is your WLTP class 3. Okay, now apply. Okay, now you can see the drive cycle source inputs are changed. Okay, now you can able to see the controllers. Here the controllers, powertrain controller. These are all a subsystem having inbuilt one. No need to create any subsystems here. Without programming knowledge, we are designing the electric vehicle. This is a specialty of this tool. Okay, this is a power management block, EV power management block. Here, these what are the inputs are there? Where input motor speed, vehicle speed, and battery power. What is the battery power consumption and state of charge model? All things are within this EV power management. These are calculate the force, torque request, and electric power request, and brake drum blending. Here is already built-in model in block power block, say especially for MATLAB powertrain block set. Okay. Here the power management bus creation with electric vehicle power management with this one. This is a block to find the motor torque versus your power input powers. It's a battery power is your design. Similarly, you are going to apply the filter here, brake command filter and the torque command filter. Here, nothing but filter is nothing but applying the transfer function to brake friction, and also there's a motor torque. Here, is nothing but is a filter. Normally, the low pass filter is used. Here, this block, this available block. Here we have which can use to this one this block parameters of drive cycle source. Determine the engine torque required to achieve the desired vehicle speed by using this, and produce a realistic closed loop acceleration and braking commands for vehicle control plant models. And also you can able to study, tune, and optimize vehicle control system performance and system robustness over multiple drive cycles. For comparison purpose, two driving cycles are used in our model NEDC, that is New European Drive Cycle, and also WETP, Worldwide Harmonized Live Vehicle Test Procedure cycles are used. Finally, we are compare the result with these two cycles. Here, what is the function of these drive cycle sources? Driving cycles are speed line graphs, nothing but speed line graphs used to calculate vehicle exhaust emissions and fuel consumptions. This is the use of this drive source block. Here this is an environmental system. We already said this one. The displays vehicle level performance, battery state of charge, and equivalent fuel economic results that are useful to powertrain matching and components selection analysis. This is a road temperature and all things we are concentrated on this design. Here the driving system, longitudinal drive subsystems is available in. This is your block, longitudinal driver model block. We are familiar with this library browser, I think. These are all the models you can drag and drop. You go to powertrain block set. Okay, all the things are available here. Just you have to drag and drop the model. For example, here go to vehicle dynamics, Yeah, these are we already mentioned what are the blocks are available. We call single degree of freedom and 3 degree of freedom model. Based on that, we are choosing the longitudinal driver model here. Here you can apply the parameters. For example, what is the nominal speed? What is the proportional gain? Kp value. These are the parameters you are going to concentrate to optimize the vehicle design. That is, the proportional gain is nothing but Kp and integral gain Ki, and this one velocity fit Kff. These are the parameters we concentrate to optimize the engine trade-off, performance versus performance also with cost. Then battery model. The EV power management is a battery block also there. The drive systems filter, we will discuss with filter. Now what is a low pass filter are used to here? This is the default one is a low pass filter. You send the low pass filter on target velocity error for smoother driving. Then this is a powertrain block model. These are control subsystems model. Here that is a EV power management block, and this is where implements the electric power plant design, including battery and motor control blocks, and implementing the motor coupling. These are motor coupling and dynamics and the battery discharge dynamics using this powertrain blocks. These are battery model. The lithium ion battery pack model is normally used in electric vehicle. Is there motor torque versus your these are all the subsystems. It's a battery model. It's a passenger car models. Is there it may be the car subsystems contains the two drivetrain blocks and the electric plant subsystems. Here let's see. Here this is a electric plant block, and this is one electric powertrain block. This one, this is an electric plant block having this motor with your battery. See, motor with this one, next one, it's a motor with battery. This is a motor with battery here, and the controller subsystem having have to implement electric power plant design, including battery and motor control blocks. Here this is a battery management block. You can see the lithium ion battery pack here. If you wish, you are change the battery model. This is also available in our Simlink model. Just you go to you have to change the battery model means just to go to library block. Here for example, here already use this one. Here you can change the initial battery capacity and output battery voltage. These are all the parameters you can able to change before you constructing the vehicle design. Then next one is up next to electric plant subsystem. Is it also having the driving subsystem, vehicle subsystem, and another one is wheels and brake subsystems. The subsystem is configured for 3 degree of freedom vehicle. And next one, for this front and rear wheel brakes, for this wheel you can configure the type of brake and force calculation, resistance calculation, and vertical motions. Here nowadays we are having the technique is regenerative braking. Somebody know about the technique? What is a regenerative braking? Using this regenerative braking, you can recover the energy at the time of slow or off the vehicle. That is a slow This also one type of energy saving technique. And force calculations are there. So there are so many forces are there when you run the vehicle on road. Here some resistance calculation also available. Here vehicle motion. Say it is in slope driving, and also so many parameters are there. Here the electric plant subsystems also having this battery and motor. Here this is a subsystem command to get the battery vehicle. This is especially EV means especially default for battery EV, electric vehicle battery. Then motor, say electric vehicle motor is a default one. These are bat EV function used to configure with electric battery. Then also mapped with your mapped motor with some form of simply implicit controller. Here you can use so many controllers you can implement here by using some other technique, advanced technique. Here also some motor with controller interior, that is a PMSM motor with controller also available using this motor generator EV dynamic subsystem block. These are all the options, sir. You can drag and drop the model. You can replace this model with this one. You can normally the default model is this mapped model. If you want to change the design, means you can call the this interior permanent magnet synchronous motor with controller block. You can add. Okay, now this visualization subsystems. You can be able to see the battery performance. That is a state of charge, and also fuel economy, and also the vehicle performance, speed and torque, and also with your real and your simulation. Real means for simulation input, that is a block library source, that is FTPR, NEDCR, WLTP source. These are all the input, that is your input drive cycle. Also you can compare with your output simulation output cycles, drive cycles. Okay, this is our output scopes. These are final output according to the simulation results. For example, we are choosing this NEDC and WTP cycles. It were understood the vehicle speed and cycle speed were the same. Here this is the output block. Here input also in the yellow color. This are output, that is our target output. The it's also merged this one. Okay, now we can see the output. Here also sample output comparison with the different drive cycles. Here previous one, the normal one, I think NEDC. This is your WLTP cycle. Here how we can change the WLTCP means, here go to source block W, already with WLTP only. If you have to change, then after simulation you change the drive cycle, that is a drive cycle source, as WTP or any other drive cycles you are based on that input drive cycles, the outputs you are getting by using this scope, visualization scope. Okay, now you can see the trace velocity versus your input versus target. Actually is in yellow color. Normal, now you can by zooming you can see these are yellow and blue color. It's same input and output. These are actual input versus your target output. It shows trace velocity and motor speed and motor torque and your fuel economy and battery current and state of charge also there. Within single window we can able to see all type of outputs. No sir, these are not optimized outputs, sir. Then next we are going to see this, sir, for decision parameters. Sir, for example, this is your WTP cycle. Based on that you can see with measurement, that is your cursor measurement. You can see, also you can see the cursor measurement with trace velocity and target velocity. What is that? time, exact time at where my cursor is placed, the time value, that's the delta t and delta y value, and also these were actual one, these were target one, these were motor speed. So peak finder, you can, there are so many options are available here to tools measurement, trace selection, cursor measurement and signal statistics, and bi-level measurements and peak finder. Here we are choosing the peak finder here. For example, trace selection, this is for trace velocity, target, this is your output, and second one, the value is changed, and motor speed, you can see the values, motor speed value in RPM and motor torque value. You can see if you are selecting, means it shows the peak, what is the peak value, it shows the output here. For motor torque means you are getting the output here, X and Y value. Now the important one is the battery state of charge. Here you can see battery of charge value, it shows in the peak value, maximum peak value. If you are measurement by using this special type of scope value, you can see the trace selection, that is trace velocity, motor speed, motor torque, and battery SOC and battery current also there. You can see battery current and fuel economy. In this manner you can get the values, that is output simulation result by using this one. Now what I do is I am changing the input cycle, drive source cycle. Here I am choosing NEDC cycle. There are so many options are there. I am choosing this one. Nowadays researchers concentrated on this NEDC and WLTLP only, so that I am choosing this one. Now these are our input block and plot cycle, the new European driving cycle. Now what happened, we'll check after the simulation. Before you select, after you select the drive cycle source, just you have to apply, then click OK, then run. Now you can see the input drive cycles is a different one. Parallel you can choose the measurement with the peak finder, that it is US fuel economic. Here the peak is available here. Now finally you got the result like this. So based on that you can check the battery charge up, state of charge. Okay, previous one, just you compare with this your previous drive cycle versus your new drive cycle for our design electric vehicle. Okay, now again in this sir, just sir, here these are all some objectives are there, charging time. For that only you are sir, just 1 minute sir, I will show you. Yeah, charging time, we're already fix this one, sir, by with battery controller. I showed one my battery model, sir. This battery model, we have to set the charging time and charging capacity and all things you have here set, sir. Then only we simulate, sir. Sir, wait, sir, 1 minute, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Here we have to set the value, sir, here for battery here initial battery capacity parameters is our output battery voltage, unfiltered or filter or unfiltered. Here we have to give the battery temperature breakpoints and number of cells in here. These are the specifications we have to include, sir. Here battery capacity, the at normal temperature battery charge maximum. Here we have to give the input, sir. Also, the state of charge percentage. Here, in the subsystem block, we are able to modify this one, sir. Similarly, you can modify the input source, the previous one is a normal one, we have TP, this is a default one, default velocity model. Based on that, we can sample output comparison with different side drive cycles. These are one standard drive cycle format, this another one is another standard cycle format. Here with the parameters time, distance, range, state of charge and energy consumption and regenerative braking. Here say we can compare that different drive cycles, what is your decent electric vehicle performance, that is a NEDC, WTP, where the simulation graph of the cycles were created by using this block set, powertrain block set. According to the simulation results, there's both NEDC and WTLTP cycles. It was understood that vehicle speed and cycle speed were the same. This is our output. Output should be same with vehicle speed and our cycle speed. At this point, it is concluded that the energy consumption data obtained from the model is also correct by using this one. Next one is a optimization block. Design and optimization of electric vehicle power management system. Here we have to concentrate on battery power is not exceeding with discharge and charge limits. This is a block to modify or optimize the parameters here. Next one, this is the energy model. Also, you have to give the performance requirement. What performance we need to require for that? See the another subsystem model. And this example. Sir, now optimization means we are concentrated on performance, the engine performance, sir. Engine performance, that is what are the parameters, throttle and manifold parameters, so many parameters are there. For example, for sensor with sensor and battery, sir, these are sensor accuracy. We are going to tune the accuracy of the sensors and tune the actuator time response, sir, by using this one, actuator, this one. So now we will change the another subsystem model. Thank you. Now this is the block for engine model, tune the engine model. Here you have to performance requirement. Here you have to mention the requirement. Here you see. Here the we have to set the input block parameters. You see, these are input parameters, input bound regions, and what time lower bound in assertion and upper bound in assertions. Here we are set the values here, bounds and assertion values. Here itself you can click the response optimization block. Now we can able to see the response optimization block. Before if you go for optimization, you can get the value. There is a run. Here we give the input as speed reference value, step time 2, initial value, sampling period, and controller. These are RPM sensors. Here, before you start optimization, you click open the session and select this energy trade-off optimization block. Then you plot the model response. Here there are options are available. Now options are available here. The value already mentioned. That's a K value, KP value, and TS value. Here if you optimize the design variables, the design variables is a K value. Here these are our performance requirements. The K value is, we set the value 3.8 is our K value, and P value 4.01, and DSET value, and also our sensor standard value and the throttle value. Okay, now you start with design variables, then click optimize. In the meantime, you can see the engine speed. Okay, now you can see the energy trade-off for this one. Previous one is normal value. Okay, now this is your output. Output of unoptimized output, this one. Here by using this response optimization tool, you can optimize the result based on our requirement. Then again, you have to optimize the, this is a design variable trade-off, then also with cost. Now we can optimize. You can see the time of best on iteration. You can see the parallel, you can see the iteration process here. This optimization started at This is for cost optimization variable value. Also, you can save the iteration value after simulation. It shows the progress report, optimization progress report here. Also, you can see the output here. The performance requirement of our engine trade-off. This one, this is our final output. This is the response output. Here you can see the that's the first iteration output values. Where already we set with this our performance requirement is upper bound and lower bound value. For optimization, it takes some more time. Now some optimization converged. At the third iteration, you will get the optimized output. The based on that, the design variables constraints is stored in the form of, you can see this is the value. It's also merged with converge is your output value. This one, the output shows based on our optimization requirement. By using this response optimization tool, you can be able to optimize the design. Here also by using this, you can generate optimization report also. This is your optimization report. Also you can save the iteration. Also you can generate the MATLAB code for this optimization. These are optimized output. These are function optimized design variables with your output. There is a solve a design optimization problem for engine trade-off. Here what are the parameters you specify the design variables and all things. Here you will get the MATLAB code. What is the use of this MATLAB code means? Here you can change the design, evaluate the design requirements value also there. It's uncertain values, it's a return values. Here you can modify the inputs values here. Engine trade-off value. Also you can use some more optimization options are available here. You can change the optimization parameter options also you can change. You can refer the response of the optimization for electric vehicle modeling. Some more optimization methods are there. Based on that, you can change the values here. Based on that, you can re-simulate your design by using this generated code, output generated code. Okay. Here, what are the optimization objective is? First one, engine performance objective. It's a maximum. These are the characteristic you assume. The maximum overshoot is 2% and rise time and settling time. These are the parameters you have to set before you optimize the design. These are all. So since the performance requirement block here, there is nothing but performance requirement block is nothing. Nothing but here you have to set the values, input values, these values, upper bound assertion values. And these are without this GUI block, that is a response optimization block, you can't able to predict the data. Here there is nothing but mask. Here is mask is available in edit mask, is available in our Simulink library. It's a mask editor. It's the name of the block is mask editor. Here you can see the response optimization GUI, the preloaded data. So response optimization, what are the title you are giving displays. Here you can change the mask value and all things. Here parameter dialog, initialization documentation, but whatever may be your response optimization GUI block is available in some Simulink library. Without this, you can't able to optimize the block, optimize the design. Okay, similarly, engine performance objective and cost minimization objectives are there for energy optimization. This is a snapshot of Simulink design optimization to optimize the speed, performance, and cost of the vehicle engine. Any doubt?
No, sir.
No doubt, Danny. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. That's all, sir. No, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, okay, some small information. Okay, some small information. This video is available in our in my YouTube channel. You can refer. If you have any doubt, means you can call or ask to sir. Yes, sir. It is also called. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Given, sir. No way. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, students.